us goalkeepers. Take your eye off the ball, make one mistake, and it's a goal. No matter how well you played before that, it's always that mistake that's remembered after the game. But when it comes down to penalties, you're not really expected to make the save. It's a no-lose situation. So when you do make the save, you're the hero of the day and remembered for all the right reasons. Hi, I'm Kevin Hanna, and today's lesson is on saving penalties. Now, by rights, us goalies should have no chance from 12 yards out, and the success rate is actually 80 to 90% in favour of the kicker. But there are tricks that we can use to help increase our odds of making the save, especially when there's some pressure on. The first thing we've got to think about is the rules. As it stands, the goalkeeper must be on the goal line between the posts. You can move from side to side on your line, but you can't move forward until the ball is actually kicked. If you do this, the ref will just order a retake. Now, the first thing we've got to do when faced with a penalty is to try and read the kicker. Watch the shooter's eyes. Often they'll give away clues, like peeking at the corner they're aiming for. Watch the approach. Is it a wide approach? Or is it straight on? A wide approach often indicates that the shooter is going towards the opposite corner. Whereas a straight on approach is much harder to read. Watch the hips. The ball goes where the hips point. Push pass shot requires the hips to open up in the direction the ball is going. Don't react too soon though. Use the clues to predict where the ball might go, but be aware. Good penalty kickers indicate they're going one way, but really go the other. A survey of all the penalties taken during the World Cup in France 98 noted that 70% of all penalties taken went to the opposite side of the kicker's dominant foot. That means that left-footed players usually hit it to their right, which is goalie's left, and right-footed players usually hit it to their left, which is the goalie's right. So if all else fails, dive left for left-footers and right for right. Now, the key word here is pressure. Even the best players in the world are prone to buckling under the pressure and the tense atmosphere of a packed stadium.
No! Argentina go through!
Now, there's a number of ways of applying even more pressure on the kicker. You could try waving your arms around and jumping from side to side a lot to try and put the kicker off. You might want to try standing on your line and wobbling your legs, a la Liverpool legend Bruce Grobbelaar. Or you could even try walking right up to the kicker and eyeballing him as he's about to place the ball in the spot. Try anything, as long as it increases the pressure on the kicker. Just beware the wrath of the referee though. Now, you should act quickly, but not too quickly. Many penalties, especially at amateur level, are poorly taken or weakly hit. You should also be aware that a lot of penalties are often hit straight down the middle, and these can often be saved just by staying where you are. So when faced with a penalty, you should be sharp, on your toes, focused and confident. You should read all the clues, but keep your eye on the ball at the point of impact and be ready to react to all eventualities. Follow these rules and you'll make that save. So there you have it. Take all this information out onto the pitch with you, and there's every chance that you could be the hero of today. and this would only increase your popularity at the bar after the match, which is always helpful.